I'm going to keep this review as brief as possible, because the more I think about it, the angrier I am going to get. When the first film in the series was released, I wasn't a fan, but I thought the concept was interesting, actually having death as a force of nature. The second film was actually better than the first, and to be honest, I did like the second film in the series. The third film is a piece of crap. This may be the worst in the series, not far behind the third, but this is really, really bad. Now, this movie is going to be a first for me because it is the first film I'm going to review that's been in 3D. I did see this film in 3D, and like I've said about animated and kids films, there is a right way and a wrong way to do it. There is a right way to do 3D. A perfect example would be the movie Up. If anyone saw that film in 3D, you will note that the film is not about things flying out at you, but showing the depth of things in the background, and it worked beautifully. Now, while I don't think the 3D made the film better, it certainly complemented it. This film is in many ways the wrong way to do 3D, because it is so gimmicky, with things just flying at you all the time. Now, in one sense, that's okay, because it's trying to just be comical and fun. So in that sense, being the gimmicky type of 3D isn't bad. However, when it's occurring every minute, it gets old and stale, and I don't want to see it anymore. And don't be worried if I'm not giving you a synopsis of the plot to this film like I typically do with my reviews. The plot to this film is exactly the same as the previous three Final Destination films. A kid sees a premonition about his own death along with his friends, they stop the deaths, but then they subsequently end up dying in the order they would have initially. If you've seen any of the Final Destination films, you know what this film is going to be. Which is the problem with this series. Every film has been exactly the same. It has new cast members, it has new directors, but it is exactly the same. Oh, and they have changed one thing. They changed the way people die. This is not horror. This isn't suspense. This isn't even thrilling. This is just exploring how many different ways we can kill people. In fact, if you want the exact same experience of this movie, I suggest you go watch Spike TV and watch that show, 1,000 Ways to Die. It's the exact same experience as watching a Final Destination film. Now, if there is one good thing I can say about this series, is that in past films, the special effects have typically been pretty good. But in this, the special effects are god-awful. And by the way, I know it's pretty much a mute point to comment on the acting in one of these films, but the acting in this film is straight out of middle school drama class. This is bad. Now, one could argue that this film is not about good acting, or good plot, or good dialogue, or anything about that. This is just about going in and having fun with splatter films. But that is the biggest problem with this film. If you have fun with that, fine, I can't argue against you. But I'm telling you right here and now that I cannot enjoy that. Because you can have a splatter flick, but still have good acting, good dialogue, and a decent plot. This film doesn't do that. So, final rating. I don't know what else to say, people. I am just sick and tired of these Final Destination films. And apparently, this one should be the last one. But you never know, some director down the road may decide to resurrect this series, but I pray he doesn't. I'm going to give this film 1.5 stars. This film is really bad, but it's not as bad as some of the other films I've seen this past year. The reason for that is because this film did have me chuckling occasionally. Some of the deaths were a bit funny. However, a couple of cheap laughs do not make up for all of the downfalls of this film. And you know what upsets me most about this film? Apparently, the makers of this film have been watching Mythbusters. Because every death in this film has been shown on Mythbusters and these deaths have been busted. The makers of this film basically just turned around and said, oh, you don't think someone's intestines can be sucked through a vacuum in the bottom of a pool? Well, guess what? We're gonna do that. That's been busted. We know that cannot happen. If nothing else, these people are dying from their own stupidity, not from freak accidents. So, take care.